Carl Hinken, folks, get him on. Come on.
Thank you very much.
All right, people. Now, everyone. So, need to be serious, I think. To whoever stole my antidepressants, I hope you're happy now. Apparently, money doesn't buy you happiness, but it does buy you drugs, and that's damn close. I've been applying for jobs lately, and I keep getting told that I'm too overexperienced. Do you know one job that you can never be too overexperienced for? Suicide bomber. Alright, it's a little bit about myself first anyway. So, I am the baby face Carl Hinken. And, random fact about myself, I have a tiny tongue. Thanks for laughing at that, a part of my body, that's great, thank you. I do, I know. To the point where an ex of mine had a nickname for me whenever he used to go down on her. She used to call me the little train that could. Couldn't, but you know. I'm quite a positive guy though. I like to be positive about things. I'm a bit of an insomniac. Do you know the best thing about being an insomniac? I am much less likely than you to get murdered in my sleep. I realised how little I owned the other day, and it made me think to myself, if only those bailiffs just knew how empty their threats were. I've got this sort of new stuff. Okay, so in general anyway, a lot of people that seem to have said before seem to think that I have some kind of disliking for people. I don't dislike people, I love them, but for the same reason I hate them, because of the stupid shit they say and the stupid shit they do all the time. It's great. Everyone does it, I do it too. The other day I was having a conversation with some girl online and she said to me, the most attractive thing that any guy can do is put in loads of effort with a girl. And I said, that's what I'm going to say, but apparently stalking is frowned upon. So there's a few things I don't get there, people say. There's a lot of sayings I don't understand. They will say to me stuff like, my mum will say to me when I lose something, she'll say, it's always in the last place you look. Yeah, of course it fucking is. Who cares on looking after you find it? I love that saying though. They say that what you don't know can't hurt you. It's not true if you've got AIDS. They also say, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. If that was true, the Olympics would be full of stroke victims. It's not true. But my favourite saying anyway, and I'll move on to some of the shit then, is when people say, it's as hard as finding a needle in a haystack. I don't get that because it really depends on a few things. First of all, the size of the haystack. Secondly, whether the needle is still attached to the crackhead or not. It makes a big change. One of the few manly stories about myself, once I tried to... I looked into joining the army, so I went down, had a conversation with them in the ball ring, and we were talking, it was all fine, it sounded good and that. Halfway through, I took off my coat, and they saw the sleeve on my arm and the tattoos on show, and apparently, if you've got a lot of tattoos on show, you're not allowed to join the army, and it made sense to them. Basically, to me, what they were saying was, it's absolutely fine for you to go off to another country, get your arm blown off, but if that arm happens to be covered in tattoos, no, you're not good enough for us. It's just stupid. It makes no sense. Skip that one. Okay. Do you remember a couple of years ago there was a lot of terrorist attacks and we found out that guys were hiring cars and most of them had come from Enterprise. Enterprise got in a bit of trouble because they weren't sure, you know, how they managed to get them, etc. And I love the pure lack of self-awareness from Enterprise. Because, I don't know if you've seen, they've got a new ad campaign going on at the moment with Gerald Butler, and he's running around with a gun, doing secret mission stuff, you know. And he runs into the car, into the Enterprise hire car, and he just comes up saying, Enterprise, whatever the mission. Think about it, come on. Oh, fucking hell. All right, last thing I'll talk about. So we're going to talk about stupid people. From that conversation, we're going to another stupid religion, and we'll go into Christianity. So I'm not a Christian or anything, but I decided to take, I had my second child, and I thought I'm going to take him to get christened. So I took him down, had a conversation with the priest, and he was like, yeah, fine, we'll do it. I know you're not a Christian, but you need to challenge my beliefs. I was like, okay, cool. Didn't want to do it too harsh anyway, but what was that person? Yeah, he was telling me about the whole, you know, Jesus turned water into wine thing. And I was like, if Jesus can turn water into wine, first of all, why is alcoholism a sin? That one was a bit, yeah. But a bit later on, he was telling me about the resurrection and all that kind of stuff, and the crucifixion. And he was telling me all about the last days and all that. And I said to him, I need to ask you something. How am I supposed to believe that a guy who can walk on water can't manage to get himself up with a piece of wood? Doesn't make sense. It was the last one he didn't like anyway, though. The last thing I said to him was, do you want to know the only difference between a religion and a cult? The success rate. Makes sense. that whole story, though, was quite enlightening to me for not the reason you think. It made me realise I was old, man. I mean, it's my second kid, taking him to get christened and that. But that wasn't the reason I felt old. It's because I realised I had that whole conversation with him, probably almost an hour, left the church, and not once did the priest try to rape me. Not once. Fucking hell. Jesus. Whoa. Alright, that's it anyway. I'm going to go on that. Dave? Thank you.